Hello friends, and welcome to the second lab of learn.net in 60 days. So let's again go and open our Visual Studio. Now in the first lab, you know, what we did is we actually displayed hello world, or I'll say this is my first program, you know, on the screen. But now in real-time scenarios, what will happen is basically you'd like to take inputs from the user and then display the data, right? It's not just displaying the data from the computer to the end user, but it's also taking data from the end user. So how can we take data from the end user and then display it in our program? So in this video, we will try to understand that how we can take inputs from the console application. So let's go ahead and again create a very simple project here. Again, this step is going to be common, console application, and we'll say lab 2 take data. Or I'll say take input data. Now, if you remember the first syntax we talked about, we set console.write line. In other words, write the data to the screen, right, to the monitor. Now, because we want to take data from the keyboard, we have to say console.read line. Okay, so you know, just to make sure, this write line sends data to the screen. Okay, it's for display purpose, and this read line takes data from the screen, from your keyboard. Okay, so these are two important syntaxes. So now, you know, okay, so this console.read line, you know, once you know, when you use this syntax, right, or when you write this code in your program will go in a wait mode. Wait mode means your program will wait until the user doesn't put anything from his keyboard. Okay, so the program will come there and it will wait until the data comes from the keyboard and the data is sent into your program. Okay, so what we have to say here is that, okay, first let's display a simple message here saying console.write line, enter your name, right? Now, once the data comes from the keyboard to your program, it has to be taken into a thing called as variable. Variables are nothing but, you know, they are small memory locations which are allocated to your computer, to your program, you know, wherein the data will come from the external world into your application, right? So what I'll do is I'm going to create a variable called a string, some data from user, whatever name I want to give here. Okay, now what this variable states here is that you are going to get some data from the keyboard, and this data will come inside this variable, right? So let me just write the syntax first, console.readline. Now look at this. Now what I'm seeing here is that the data will come from the keyboard, that is read line, into my variable called as some data from user, right? So, and after that I'll say console.write line hello, you have entered. Now whatever data is there, it comes into this some data from user. So I'll say you have entered some data from user. Now you can see this plus sign here. This plus sign says that join this sentence and join this data which has come from the keyboard. In other words, if I enter here Shiv, then you can the data will be displayed. Hello, you have entered Shiv. If I enter here good morning, then I'll get a sentence here saying hello, you have entered good morning. Okay, so variable is nothing but, you know, they are small chunk of memory which are allocated to your program, and you know, this chunk of memory will hold some kind of data. Okay, so I'll do a control F5 here, and what I'll do is, and okay, before I do a control F5, after this console.write line, right, I would like to just go and do a read line here, you know, so that the program does not finish, because what will happen is, or else, you know, if I put something here and I do enter, you know, the straightforward, you know, the program will go off. Okay, so I have, you know, this one, this small sentence here, you know, will ensure that our program is still running and we can see the output. Okay, so let me do a control F5 here. So you can see now the code has executed this first line of code, console.write line, right, and it has displayed enter your name. Now it is waiting for the second line over here saying that you have to enter some data. So I'm going to say good evening. Okay, oh, this is my name. Okay, sorry. So I'm going to say Shiv, and I'm going to do enter. Now you can see what it has done is whatever I have entered, right, this Shiv data has gone inside this some data from user, the variable, right? And then later this variable data is concatenated, or it is joined, you know, with this sentence, hello, you have entered Shiv, and it is displayed, right? And our program finishes. So basically, you know, if you want to display data on the screen, you will use console.write line. If you want to read data from the keyboard, then you will use console.read line. So I hope that you have enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand that how we can take data from the keyboard inside our C# program.